Hello students, welcome to the next lecture of the double and triple integral. In the last lecture we had talked about the questions that how to solve the double integral or how to find out the area of the given figure with the help of a horizontal or a vertical strip. Today we will talk about the integration by changing the Cartesian coordinate into spherical coordinate. So spherical coordinates are basically three-dimensional coordinates which are represented by r, which is the radius, theta and phi, the two angles. So let us understand how we can convert the Cartesian coordinates, where we consider three axes, x, y and z. So how we convert the Cartesian coordinate into a spherical coordinate? So let's see, these are some important things to note down, that in Cartesian coordinate x is equivalent to the r sine theta cos phi into the spherical coordinate. Similarly, y is equivalent to r sine theta sine phi and z is equivalent to r cos theta. Now if we need to evaluate the volume, then we will be requiring the value of dx, dy, dz. So this is equivalent to mod of Jacobian dr d theta d phi, where the value of the Jacobian in the case of spherical coordinates have been given. This is r square sine theta. So mod of Jacobian is equal to r square sine theta. And so now the dx dy dz is equivalent to r square sine theta dr d theta d phi. By replacing all these values, you can convert any question which is given into the Cartesian coordinate into spherical coordinate. So now let's see that in a sphere, if we are considering a sphere, then we know the equation of a sphere is x square plus y square plus z square is equal to a square. This is the equation of the sphere in Cartesian coordinates. Now in the polar coordinates, the r varies from 0 to a. As we can see, this equation is giving us the indication that the radius of the sphere is a. So r will move from 0 to a. The theta will move from 0 to pi and the phi will move from 0 to 2 pi. That means the lower limit of r is 0, upper is a, the lower limit of theta is 0, upper is pi, and lower limit of phi is 0 and upper is 2 pi. So by performing these substitutions, we can convert any Cartesian coordinate into polar spherical coordinates. Then we can solve the question. So let's see an example. So evaluate triple integral dx dy dz divided by x square plus y square plus z square throughout the volume of the sphere, x square plus y square plus z square is equal to a square. So the equation of the sphere is given and we need to find out the volume. So from the equation we can find that the radius of the sphere will be given by a. Now let's see how this equation is solved. As we have just seen, that just by converting the Cartesian coordinates into the spherical coordinates, it will be easier for us to solve it. So we have to substitute x by r sine theta cos phi, y by r sine theta sine phi and z by r cos theta, and we need to replace this dx dy dz by the Jacobian of dr d theta and d phi. So here the Jacobian was r square sine theta, so this is replaced by r square sine theta dr d theta d phi. And as in the question, this x square plus y square plus z square will be replaced by the equation of the sphere, that x square plus y square plus z square is always equal to r square. So this is replaced by r square. As we know, sphere is a three-dimensional figure and it will be covering all the eight coordinates. So, eight coordinates and the area on all the eight coordinates will be symmetric, because into the given question, the sphere is onto the center of the sphere is onto the origin. So, we will find out the area of the single section, or we will find out the area of the single, we can say that in between the x and y axis, or single plane or single octant, and then we will multiply it by 8, because we have in total 8 planes in the 3 dimension system. So in the single plane, let's say if we are considering the xy plane, that what will be the limits. So where r is the radius, so it will move from 0 to a. Obviously in one plane, that is xy, the theta will be 0 to pi by 2. Any single plane carries 90 degrees. So if this is let's say we are considering this section, so this angle will be pi by 2. Similarly, the z or the phi will also move from 0 to pi by 2. So these are the limits, and by doing this we will be able to count or calculate the volume into one section, and that has to be multiplied by 8. So now we have separated how to evaluate the integral. So we have separated these integrals dr, d phi and d theta. So first we will integrate the dr part. So we have this r, then we will integrate this theta part with the minus of cos theta, sine theta. The integral of sine theta is minus of cos theta, and lastly the phi. So just by substituting these values, we could find out the final value and putting the limits. So this is 4a pi. So this is the volume of the sphere. So you can closely look into the solution for the integration process, for substituting the limits. You can pause the video and you can have a look. And finally, we have the solution as 4a pi. So thank you for the lecture. In this lecture we had discussed the spherical coordinates and we had solved an example that is based on spherical coordinates. We learned how to convert the Cartesian coordinates into the spherical coordinates. In the next lecture we will be solving the cylindrical coordinates. We will be seeing how we can convert the Cartesian coordinates into the cylindrical coordinates, and we will solve a few questions on it. Thank you so much.